Before Theodore Roosevelt was president, he was a member of the First United States Volunteer Academy, known forever as the Rough Riders, for indeed they were a determined conservationist and a true patriot.
Roosevelt became president at the start of a brand new century in a new young nation called the United States of America.
Do what you can with what you have where you are!
By the time America was only 100 years old, it had already made its mark as one of the greatest nations of history of civilization.
Yet there were only 8,000 cars.
And 10 miles of paved roads.
The average worker made $12.90 a week.
President Roosevelt said,
"The government is us. We are the government. You and I."
Then he said,
"Far and away, the best prize in life has to offer is the chance to work hard and work worth doing."
And finally, he said,
"I am an only average man, but by George, I work harder at it than the average man."
That was the character of 1901 America.
As the world turned into a new century, America was turning into a place where everybody wanted to be.
Each year, the first night of 1904, and the place to be was St. Louis, Missouri, for the Louisiana Purchase Exposition, or commonly known as the World's Fair.
Thank you. 11th month.
Extra, extra, we don't call it, more than the war's over.
The country and the world were emerging from a rough era of war and epidemic.
There was even talk of revenge against the countries that seemed to have
President Woodrow Wilson said,
peace has to be peace of reconciliation. Peace without victory, for a victor's peace would leave a stain, a resentment, a bitter memory upon which terms of peace would rest, not permanently, but only as a conquest.
From this idea, the League of Nations was formed.
America's not anything if it consists of each of us. It is something only if it consists of all of us.
All together, America was ready to celebrate and have some fun. So the 1920s came in with roar and the dance of Cat's Meow.
Everybody jump, everybody sing.
World War I was supposed to be the war to end all wars, but that was not the case. In the 1940s, World War II broke out and the American soldiers were back in the battlefields of European nations.
Young women were working in factories back home to support the war and as nurses on the war.
Young men were signing up in droves and being shipped all over the world as defenders of freedom and liberty.
Once again, families and friends were separated and the loneliness war took a toll on all Americans.
And yet it was a promise of being back together with family and friends, boyfriend and girlfriends, brothers and sisters, moms and dads, and all fellow American survivors of separation who believe in brighter days.
It has been almost 11 months since I last saw you, but I look at your picture many times a day and night and read your letters over and over. This war in Europe rages on and on, as it does in Asia and seems like every other part of the world.
I cannot tell you where I am, but it is very cold and wet and as lonely as can be. I can't wait till this war is over and I can come home. No need to worry, Mom and Papa will be home real soon.
Thank you. Is the front cut? Oh, it's stabilized. Yeah, I gotta stand for it. You gotta be a little
Yeah.
funny. I believe that man is a hippie. I can't tell if it's a boy or a girl with that long hair. Be careful, dude. You don't know what they've been into.
You gotta chill, man. That's gonna be that.
It's so true. In the 1960s and 70s, many Americans disillusioned by yet another war, which seemed to be an impossible generation gap.
America was ready for a period of peace, love, and brotherhood. Right on.
Now are the new American Voices.
As we grow and learn from those who have